It's always about the Terrans, like, because they have personalities and they speak the same language as us or whatever, but I want to read a comic book or a novel about a Zerg platoon. How cool would that be? Oh my god, I was talking about Zerg comic books, and in the meantime, these stalkers came up here and attacked, and it looks like they didn't, he does pull drones. Pilots are pretty good against stalkers, dude. I don't think you need to lose all these drones, but he still is mining pretty healthily over here. And ooh, and then the simultaneous warp prism drops. Sexy, sexy. Gotta love that. And sorry, let me move this. So he distracted everything over here, and then simultaneously dropped and warped in. Dropped immortals, and then warped in some stalkers. That's pretty cool. Actually, I really like that play. Very impressive play from Ichiban. I mean, I'd still kick his ass, but, you know. I'm totally kidding, okay? I'm not your run-of-the-mill commentator. I'm sorry. Pretty good. Pretty good. And let's see what's Megan made now. Just not much over in the Zerg base. Taking a look at the army composition. Immortal, and he is way ahead in the probes versus drones. I mean, every game, this Zerg is getting out-probed. So, you know, that's not so good. You don't want that. Of course, he doesn't have the expansion up yet, so he's not getting full use of all these probes, but it's still really good. He's going to have a nice fat transfer. And there's one thing I love. It's a fat transfer. Nidus. Yes, thank you. I don't know why this building doesn't get made more often. It's so good. It's so beautiful. It's so cool. It makes you such an impressive player when you use it, you know? And we're gonna see how it goes. Where is that Overseer? He morphed that. Oh, he's got Overlord speed and an Overseer, so we're gonna see some good Nidusing. And this is a really good map for Nidus, because, I mean, just this big blank area up here. He's already got nice vision on it. Didn't even need to bring this Overseer. But he's using it for scouting anyways, just to see how vulnerable... Okay, thanks for pinging the Zelnaga Watchtower. Just how vulnerable the Protoss base is right now, which is pretty damn vulnerable. That's the answer. But the Overseer is going to go down, so there's 100 gas down the drain, but well worth it, because here comes the Nidus. Oh, I'm so excited. And no counters ready, except for maybe warping in a few stuff here, but nothing major. So we're going to see a pretty devastating... drop here from Zerg. I guess it's a drop. Can't really call it a Nidus drop. And he begins wreaking havoc. And in the meantime, here comes the Protoss force to fight it. And it looks like he is going to be able to hold this off, but he is doing some good damage. And get back in. Oh, is he going to get back in? Or is he going to... Oh, he's got a bunch more stuff in. He's not going to get back in. He's going to kill him. Oh, very nice. Nidus. I love this. I love seeing this. I mean, if you guys watch my videos at all, you know how much I love the Nidus Worm. I think it's so underused. And as you can see now, this is going to be a pretty close to GG scenario for Protoss. Hydralis are just in here ripping stuff up. Really good Nidus. Killing probes. Kill every probe and then leave. Screw it. No, don't shoot them. But more coming in. And, Hydralis using their mega headbutt. Did you see that? They had a cool melee attack. I've never seen that. But, he really should have just killed as many drones as he could have right there. But, oh well, it was still really good. And as you can see, the only unit that... Oh, probably not good tonight is that. Cancel it. Save yourself 100 gas. No! The only unit that he had was stalkers. I mean, probes. And now he has a few stalkers. So, way behind his Protoss now. And, one thing I've got to criticize is expandering that. Macros... really not good right now for Solaris in this series. 2,000 minerals makes me like I get a little gag reflex. I'm like, oh. Like, dude, triple expand during that attack. Why not? You know, like, you have such a huge swing forward. Use it, you know, absolutely exploit it to the fullest. And here's another Nidus here. Interesting placement. He is going to shoot this. It's not like you can't afford Nidus Worms, that's for sure. Expand! Expand, just expand everywhere. Damn it, man. Spend your money. Killing me. Get some upgrades. I Tell me you're using this. Tell me. Okay, sorry. I am not going to give him any more crap because he got to the finals of this tournament and I didn't. Granted, I wasn't in this tournament because I work on Saturdays. Yeah, I'm not going to be in this tournament anytime soon, guys. I'm sorry. But if the day gets moved or if I get a Saturday off or Sunday off, I will definitely participate because I love this tournament. I think it's so cool. And Nidus is a little gross, not going to lie. There's the Nidus chain. Why get out if you're just going to get right back in? But whatever. And Protoss just struggling. Struggling real hard to get stuff back up. He's got 8 Stalkers, 7 Zealots. I don't think that's going to be too great. And love this use of the Nidus. It's good use of the Nidus. It's not good use of the advantages the Nidus gives you. I've got to reiterate. 1,400 minerals. Expand, dude. Then you'll have lots of gas. And then you can spend everything. But killing lots of probes. Yeah, this game's over. There's no recovering from this. The heavy losses in economy that Protoss has sustained. Taking a look over here. 26 probes to almost 50 drones. And even if Zerg doesn't spend his money, if he gets in trouble, he'll have plenty of reserves to spend, but it looks like he's not going to get in trouble. He's just going to win instead. Lots of cannons going down from a panicked Ichiban Baka. He's going to do everything in his power to try and pull this game out, but... Yes, thank you! He did it once, ladies and gentlemen. He could have this entire map. Oh, it'd be so beautiful. Can you guys tell him I'm a closet. Sorry, I hit my microphone. Can you guys tell him a closet Zerg fan? Like, I secretly want to play Zerg. Well, I do, but I just love Terrans too much. They just fit my playstyle so well, and I think they're the coolest. So, but I might dabble. I think I'm gonna start dabbling with this Nidus expansion style, and I'm just gonna live on Desert Oasis and like never leave it, and like just live in a hut and just Nidus everyone all day. Crotchety old man with a Nidus worm and a cane. So here comes more Hydras pouring out. Looks like he is going to try and break this. I think he will be fine, especially with this second group coming in. And so we're going to see a GG real soon from Ichiban Baka. There's absolutely nothing he can do here. Here comes the attack around here. And yeah, that'll do it. Any upgrades on these guys? No upgrades. It pains me to see these things, but it was a good game from Solaris. He used the map well, used Nidus's, and I always love when people use Nidus's. So good game. We are going to game 5 for the first time ever in this tournament series, which has not been long, admittedly. We're going to an ace match. The finals. The match point. It's going to be very exciting. And I hope to see you there in game 5. All right. See you soon.